A New House for Mouse by Peter Horacek. A New House for Mouse. One day, a little mouse looked out of the tiny hole where she lived and saw a big apple. "I would like that apple to eat," said little mouse. "I must bring it inside." She tried and tried, but she couldn't pull the apple through the tiny hole. "My little house is too small," said little mouse. "I will look for a bigger one." So off she set. "Looking for a new house makes you hungry," said little mouse, as she took a few bites of the juicy apple. Then she spotted a hole that was just a little bigger than hers. "This looks just right," she said as she looked inside. "Hello, mole. I need a bigger house for my apple and me. May I live here with you?" "I'm sorry," mumbled Mole, "but my home is too full of books. I don't think there is room for both of us." "I will keep looking," said Little Mouse. Soon, Little Mouse felt hungry again. "I'll just have a nibble," she said to herself. Then she spotted a hole that was just a little bigger than Mole's. "That will be perfect," she said. She looked inside. "Hello, Rabbit," she said. "I'm looking for a bigger house for my apple and me. May I live here with you?" "I'm sorry," twittered Rabbit, "but my home is too full of cabbage. I don't think there is room for both of us." "Perhaps not," said Little Mouse. Little Mouse set off again, but she was still hungry, so she nibbled on the apple as she went. Then she spotted another hole that was just a little bigger than Rabbit's. "That will be just right," she said. She looked inside. "Hello, Badger," she said. "I am looking for a new home for my apple and me. May we come and live with you?" "I'm sorry," barked Badger, "but I stretched out on my cushions all day, sleeping. I don't think there's room for both of us." "Perhaps not," said Little Mouse, feeling rather tired and still hungry. She nibbled on the apple once again. That evening, she came across an enormous hole. "This must be big enough for my apple and me," she thought. "Hello, is anybody there?" she shouted. "Hello, little mouse," growled Bear. "Why don't you come and live here with me?" "No, thank you," squeaked little mouse. "I think the cave is too small for you and me and my apple." And off she ran. Little Mouse was very tired now, but pulling the apple seemed easier. Suddenly she saw a tiny hole. "That looks perfect," she squeaked. She looked inside. There was no one at home. Little Mouse went right in and pulled her apple behind her. It fit perfectly. "I knew I would find somewhere just right for both me and my apple," she said, and she climbed into her own bed and fell fast asleep. The end.